Good morning and welcome to this morning's reflection, and I'm glad that we could be together again this morning and this week we will continue to look at the work of John Ortberg from his book, If You Want to Walk on Water, You Have Got to Get Out of the Boat. And last week we ended by looking at discernment and in particular discerning our limitations. Paul calls us to regard ourselves with sober judgment, to come to a place of truly knowing who we are, well, as much of who we are as we can possibly know, to come to a place of having some sense of what our passions are, what our gifting is, and what our limits are. And to do this is really quite hard, it's challenging. And so it's quite helpful at times to get others involved, to ask others to help you to discern your calling. Because others can often help us see our blind spots, those parts of ourselves that is very difficult for us to see, and that often are blatantly obvious to others. This process of discernment is not something that will happen overnight, and we have to be patient. We cannot microwave discernment. We have to allow God to lead us to a place of hearing our calling. People sometimes romanticize the notion of calling. Receiving a calling from God is not the same as living your dream life. If you are honest, your dream life is often about security and comfort. But a calling is something that is very different. When God called Moses, he said, in essence, Moses, go to Pharaoh, the most powerful man on earth. Tell him to let his labor force leave without compensation, to worship a God that he does not believe in, and then convince a timid, stiff-necked people to run away into the desert. That, Moses, is your calling. How did Moses respond? He said, Here I am, Lord. Send Aaron. Yes, we always have got someone else in mind for God's calling. Why? Because very often God's calling makes us feel utterly inadequate. The first response to a God-sized calling is generally fear. Deep fear. So if what you think God is calling you to seems to you to be like somewhat of a walk in the park, maybe it isn't a calling from God. Because God's calling always tends to stretch us, tends to deepen and grow our gifting. When God calls us, it's a space in which he demonstrates his strength, his provision, and his kindness. God's call is to use our gifts, but we cannot use them alone. We will need God's help. We work with God in our calling. It's important to realize that a calling often comes with a very high price. It may mean putting in hours of work and effort, when you would much rather be doing something else. Will you still get out of the boat? It may be that your calling will give you very little recognition, no vote of thanks. Your calling may even be an unseen service. Will you still get out of the boat? You may well experience disappointment and discouragement. Will you still get out of the boat? People may oppose you. People may disapprove of you. People may even attempt to block what you are doing. Will you still get out of the boat? A calling is something that I do for God. But alongside our calling, we may also have a career or other work which we do in order to earn money or to give meaning to our lives. And sometimes a career or other work that we do can become our religion. It can become the thing that we worship and that we give all of our time to, and can detract from us being able to commit to the calling that we have received. And so sometimes our career or our work can in fact become our God. Our career or our work of some kind is something we choose, but a calling is something that we receive. A calling is something from which we never retire. When God calls us into a sacred work, He enables us to do it, even in the most unlikely of circumstances. Scripture is full of people who were pressed into slavery, captured, sent into exile, or thrown into prison. Their career trajectories did not look promising, but they fulfilled their callings in an extraordinary way. Pharaoh had a career, but Moses had a calling. Potiphar had a career, but Joseph had a calling. Haman had a career, but Esther had a calling. Ahab had a career, but Elijah had a calling. Pilate had a career, but Jesus had a calling. Sometimes, when we come to the end of our careers, our calling truly begins. Sometimes when we fail spectacularly in our careers, our calling truly begins. You and I have a calling. We are not spare parts. We are not sitting on the bench. We are not retired. We are on a mission from God. But remember that as we progress on this journey, we grow into our calling. We are never ready for the calling when we are called. It is truly a process of becoming. Amen.